Adobe improved its new Firefly design model and is coming with AI superpowers that will blow your mind. In this video, I will highlight the most interesting Adobe Max announcements from the conference. I don't know even where to start with so many great things. Okay, get ready because this will be nuts. So let's start with Photoshop and its new Generative Expand. I have here a photo of a forest, but I think it's too vertical and I want to make it more landscape mode. So you can now select the crop tool to expand the canvas, and then if you click in generate in the contextual bar, Photoshop will magically add background to that missing part of the image. Bam! It looks pretty good. You can switch between other two suggestions and select what you want. Then I will try to add another element to the composition, so with the lasso tool, I will roughly make a selection. And type in the contextual bar, hold 3, because I want to create depth in the image. Nice. So now let's try even one more thing. Still with the lasso tool, let's quickly make a selection here in the center. And I want a forest waterfall. Let's see what we get. Okay, this one doesn't look so good. Let's see the other solutions. This one is pretty nice. I think I will use this one. Now let's move to another image. In this one, I'll use the lasso tool to make a selection. And I will type hummingbird and see what you get. And here's our little birdie. Now this image looks too old and have some issues, so let's select some parts in the image that we want to fix and try to restore it. Now let's generate. And bam, here's your fixed image. Another great feature is the background removal or change, so quick select the subject, invert selection, and generate a colorful brick wall. Not satisfied with the results, smash that generate button again, and now you have a better result. Photoshop Generative Fill is so much fun now. Okay, let's see now what we have on Lightroom. Let's say I want to change a little bit the color of our jacket. We have now this point color feature that will help us pick a color in our image, and then we can play around in this color box to adjust and change the colors. Look, so cool. And Lightroom has also this new feature, the lens blur, that will also be a big help when we want to blur our backgrounds. So look at how easy it identifies the subject from the background and transforms the image so well. Alright, let's move to Illustrator. So imagine that you are exploring the mood board for your work and you have different screenshots. We have here some raster images, no vector, and I want to discover what font this is. We all been here, right? So I will pick this screenshot, upload to a website, try to match the font and go search for it. Right now, with the new retype tool, we select the image and run the tool and Illustrator will find the font for me. Will tell if I already have the font in my computer or suggest similar ones. So you really quickly find the font, and now get ready for this. Illustrator not only finds the font, but it converts it back to editable text. Let's pick this one, click enter. Illustrator finds the font. It exits, and bam, you can now edit the text. So awesome. Okay, now imagine that you are working with several illustrations and you have some color patterns already, in this case in some mandalas, but you have one that needs to recolor. You can go and paint over it, and it may took a while, but right now if you click here in recolor, To open up this pop-up, you select here Generative Rig Color, and you can select from these default sets or type your prompt to generate the style you want. I think I'm going with this one. So as you may notice already, just like in Photoshop, we have in Illustrator the contextual bar to generate icons, scenes, you name it. So let's quickly drag here a rectangle shape with no fill and type simple dog shape icon. And bam, you got three variations of illustration. I will choose this one, and now that's the catch. If you click, you can actually edit the lines because this is a vector. So cool. Alright, let's try something more complicated. Let's type a small cute astronaut. And look at that. We got three awesome results. And you can also use the generative recolor to change the colors if you want. You need to try yourself. It's so easy now to create patterns. Let's create one. Draw a rectangle and type the prompt autumn leaves. And set here in this icon to patterns. Let's wait a little bit. And ooh, there you have it! And all of these illustrations that we've done are all vectors, so you can customize even further. Let's rock on to the next app new features, Adobe Premiere Pro. In Premiere Pro, we also have amazing new features. I was not able to test it for some reason. I have updated Premiere, but some features are not appearing in the app, so I will quickly highlight the keynote from Dacia. First feature is the new automatic transcription of your videos. It's really great to automatically get transcripts of your videos because you don't need to watch the entire video if you want to catch up some parts of the text. And Premiere automatically highlights the text on blue while you are talking. Now you can also select parts of the text, and by clicking insert icon, it will automatically add the part of the video cutted into the timeline. I'm imagining this saving so many time. And you can do that with multiple videos, they will automatically be added to your timeline. Another great feature, and I think this is one of the most relevant in Premiere Pro, was to remove the filler words. Yes, those you don't need to watch the video again to find them. The filler words remover tool does it for you. So let's listen to the before.
So I remember the first time when I painted a mural, it really blew my mind.
And now listen the after.
So I remember the first time when I painted a mural, it really blew my mind because...
And also Premiere has now finally the enhanced speech inside the app, finally. So if you go into the essential sound panel, you have the enhance button that quickly improves the sound. Let's listen this.
And this mosaic that's right behind us where you see it, them working, it's a gift. It's a gift.
And, there you go. Now let's talk about Adobe Express. Some of you may know this app already, but for those of you who don't know, this app helps you create quick and easy social content for websites, blogs, and social media in so many different formats. You have a big amount of templates that you can use to start, but in this case, I've created a poster already in Illustrator. So let's add new template media. Let's use this poster that I've created in Illustrator, and it will import with all layers. And as you can see, I have here all layers that I have on my original working file, and you can edit them here. Add strokes, change colors. This is so helpful. Cool, so now I can animate these elements. Let's say I want these smoke clouds to have some motion. Go to animation and explore what we have here. I will go with this breathe effect. Then I will apply also to all smoke clouds. Next up, I want to add motion to the rocket. Maybe this yo-yo movement with the direction upwards. And the same for the rocket fire. Let's play the animation. Love it! But if you hit here, edit timeline, you can add more things to the video. You can use a video from library, let's search some space video and drag to the timeline. Run this and there you go, you have your animation done. So easy as that. Now let's say that you may want to share this with your marketing team but want to keep some graphics locked, so that they cannot change. You can lock them down. Now you are the marketing guy and receives this and wants to publish in the social media, but you have only one file. The new resize tool lets you quickly create the social media templates. Just select what you want and bam, in seconds you have this adapted to so many different sizes that you selected. Next step will be schedule, right? Right now in Adobe Express you have content schedule that you can publish to Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, and Adobe mentioned that you are now able to post on TikTok, Instagram Reels and Instagram Stories. Isn't this so helpful? You set the date. And now you can see it in your content calendar. There's also a new translate feature that translates your work into several languages, so let's select a few and see what happened. And now you have your work translated into more languages. Adobe also showed the new text-to-template feature, which allows you to type a prompt and in some seconds you have different ideas for templates that you can start work on. Absolutely amazing! Yes, you have a lot of templates available in the library, but if you are in a mood and don't find what you want, just type it and see what you get. So here, let's type summer party poster, illustration style, and see what we get. Interesting ideas for a starting point. Let's say I want this one. You can edit, change the position of objects, change colors, anything you want. And last but not least, the mind-blowing new Firefly Image Model tool. Yes, it's now better than before. You already saw in this video what this AI model is capable of. You have now access to higher quality and more realistic images, the ability to apply specific styles to images, image settings like depth and motion blur, prompt suggestions while typing. So let's explore a bit. I have here some good sloth and they are already very good, but I want something more realistic. So let's try 3D render. Cool, but still I want it to be more real. So let's remove 3D render. And look at this. Let's zoom in here. Look at the fur. So realistic. Now let's try with real people. Group of friends. And generate. Whoa, impressive! They look very real. Let's zoom in some. Yeah, we have some defects here, but in general they are so realistic. Let's play around with something else. Look at this, so real. You have now Midjourney, DALL-E, Leonardo AI and Adobe Firefly putting so much quality here. Another new feature is Reference Image Gallery. So let's say you want a specific style, but don't know the name. Just head over to this gallery and see if you find it. Then it's just generate. I get lost here, the possibilities are endless to get inspiration. And you also have the general gallery to see other generated images, to be inspired, and you have also access to the prompt. It's open to you to explore. And that's it for now. What was the most impressive feature for you? What do you think about all of these new AI features coming in mass to our toolset. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave your like and subscription here in the channel, and catch up you guys in the next video. Thank you and have a great day.